Good evening.
Tonight, I'm going to share with you a workshop on how to evaluate to motivate. So, as the Toastmaster Evening has mentioned, I have joined Toastmaster last year, and I was asked to start evaluating on speakers around October. And at first, it was hard for me. It was really, really hard for me. But then, I had people that I talked to and along the way that helped me in giving me tips on how to do an evaluation. And tonight, I'm going to share with you some of the thoughts and some of the tips that I've learned for the past few months on how to evaluate to motivate. Now, first of all, what's the benefit of doing an evaluation? Can anyone have any ideas on why do we need to do evaluations?
Constructive criticism.
I would say constructive feedback rather than criticism. Itself is already a negative word. We are talking about evaluating to motivate.
Yeah, I regret saying that.
Now, the first thing is providing immediate feedback. Now, as a Toastmaster, we talk about a platform to learn. And what's the best way to learn immediately after you doing a speech? Your evaluators will be writing down notes, points, and areas where they think that you could even do better or what you have already done well. So it's an immediate feedback. Second, it offers us an idea on how to improve. For example, a particular manual can be on vocal projection, and you might be talking softly, like Tom and Jerry. Like Jerry, not Tom. So, and most important is we're trying to help the speaker to build up their self-esteem, to have the courage to continue to speak on the stage. Now, when members join, they do speech, they hope they could improve. Now, even though they are not good initially, you can't just go by saying, you just started, you can't do anything, you have nothing at all. You can't do it that way. They might jump off the building the next day. So that's the last thing that we want. What we want is we need to continue to motivate them to continue to do the speeches and continue to improve, because their improvement equals to our value as well. So, how to evaluate effectively? There are 6 steps. Number 1, before the speech, try and talk to the speaker. Find out what's the objective of the speech today. You might be doing a certain manner and you'd like to find out, so what are you expecting out of the speech today? Robin was doing this CC1, and as an evaluator, you might want to find out with Robin, hey Robin, how's it going? What are you expected of yourself today? Maybe not so much for icebreaker, because this is where we try to find out what or whom Robin is. Probably starting CC2 to CC3, where you talk about organizing a speech or body language. And Robin might say that, actually, I'm not confident with my body language. I felt like I might be, the only thing I know is dancing. I can dance and keep on my way through a whole speech, but I do not know how to move with a purpose. Then when you are doing your evaluations, you know where is the focal point. Next, we need to show interest. Your speaker is speaking in front, and you can't just sit there with both your hands on your chin. When are you going to finish? It's about 3 minutes in time. You need to show full attention to your speaker. Now this is what we meant by you need to show the interest.
Sorry guys, just